you fucking redneck.
What's happening over there? You were giving me a signal before. The dude in the yellow, you were giving me a signal. You came over and gave me a hand signal. Okay. You just have headphones on. How are you watching a comedy show with headphones on? No, you will not get the mic. You're dumb enough to watch a comedy show with headphones. You think I'm going to give you the mic? Do you? This isn't how comedy works, man. You can't just, like, say a mean thing that makes no sense.
Hey, you talking to me? Then get that mic. I can show you how to do comedy. I can
take it. No, that's not how it works. No, your school's paying me a lot of money to prevent you from doing things like this. Do you see how everyone laughed when I said something and didn't when you said something? Because that's how this works. You have a good day, sir. Oh, man. I apologize for those McDonald's jokes. I didn't mean to offend you. Still wearing the uniform. I want to know, like, in his headphones, was he just listening to, like, a motivational tape before that happened? Was that just Eminem from 8 Mile? Just be like, you only got one shot. And then he did it, and his one shot did not work out in his favor. Oh, man. I'm okay with it. I only got another 10 minutes up here. You got to be in class with him for 2 years, so...
I Someone playing a cricket sound effect? Or is there a cricket in the room, or is there a total fucking dick in the room? Which of the two happened? The cricket stopped, so it was a total fucking dick. Good to know that someone thinks they're better than us, and they're fucking wrong. Don't do that shit. Don't ever fuck with someone with a microphone and a sense of humor. Don't ever do that. I know someone did that because they were like, oh, it'd be really funny. I downloaded an app that makes me cool. Here's the deal. Don't ever do that. Comedians were funnier than you. I don't mean to bruise egos. Everyone thinks they're funny and that's okay. Every guy especially. Every guy in this room is like, I'm funnier than that guy. My dick is bigger too. And for God's sakes, I'm 6'4". I'm funny. Joke for the ladies. I told someone I was funnier than him once and he got mad at me. He was like genuinely mad at me. He goes, you're not funnier than me. I'm like, sir, I'm a professional comedian. Clearly I'm funnier than you. He goes, you're a douche. I'm a what?
You're a feminine hygiene product, man.
I told him he was right. I am a douche. Because after I fucked his mom, she smelled better. Still want to play your fucking cricket?
Why did your uncle tell you that vest looks cute?
Oh, you fucking redneck. This is what adults wear sometimes. Like, we have, like, fashion and taste and shit. I can't see you from here, but what gas station t-shirt are you wearing? Did they at least spell farted right in the who farted? Did they? Or is it like a knockoff where it says, like, who furred it? Yeah, it was only $3, so you're like, I'm gonna wear that. And by the way, call my vest stupid all you want, but your assumption that you're going immediately to Uncle Molestation says so much more about you than it does about me.
What's it say that I'm wearing a purple collared shirt?
You're wearing a purple collared shirt.
Yeah.
Okay, it says that your girlfriend and her wife dress you against your will.
Hey, that's my son, and you're right.
What?
That's my son, and you're right.
That's a mystic. He said, "That's my son, and you're right." And sir, that's your son. Please tell me that you're still in touch with your brother.
I love my life.
Not in touch that way. So when I say, would you like to ask a question, I don't mean to take a shot at me. Because you're gonna fucking lose.
You enjoyed my set tonight.
I have 6 different comedy albums. They're all material you did not hear tonight. They're all different from each other. Normally they're $10 a piece, but what I would like to do here is give all 6 of them to you for 20. Here's why I do that.
I don't care.
Okay. You said you don't care in the way of like you'll pay for all 60, or in the way of like even for free I won't take them.
I'm just fucking with you.
You're just fucking with me? Oh, so you just wanted to be a dick?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, mission accomplished. You came here to be a dick, and then you was like, here's the time to be a dick, and then I was like, okay. So when you said you don't care, were you worried that the other people did, and you might be lumped into that group?
I love you.
You love me. Okay. You weird way of showing it. That was like some second grader shit right there. Like, I love you. I'm gonna pinch you and punch you because I love you. Sir, what do you do for a living?
I don't care.
Okay, so. If this is love, I don't want love. Are you married, sir?
No.
No? Have you ever been married?
Yes.
Yes. And so you got divorced. Was it over shit like this?
I'm a widow.
What?
I'm a widow.
You're a widow? Okay. Oh, I don't feel bad about it. He was a dick to me. Stop it. All right, I feel a little bit bad. Holy shit. Damn it, that was the one answer that made this joke not funny. How dare you? How dare you let your wife die? Well, you know what? No. Because here's the thing. I don't care. So.
Black better than you.
What? Did you say you like Jay Black better than me?
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. Remember that part where I said if you don't like something, you don't have to tell people so that you're not a dick? I'm glad that you like him. He's one of my closest friends, and I think it's wonderful. And what I'm going to do is after the show, because he had to run back to his room, so what's going to happen is after the show, I'm going to be like, hey, Jay, you have a fan in the crowd. And he's going to be like, that's awesome. And be like, yeah, but he's a real fucking dick. And Jay's going to be like, I don't want dicks to be my fans. And be like, I'm sorry, man, you do very well with the dick demographic. I apologize, but total assholes completely love you. Your biggest fan in this room is a total fucking dick. But Jay Black was very funny. Good point. So here's what I want to do to close the show out here. I'm going to let you guys participate.
Oh my God, this motherfucker's talking about Fresno. What up?
What?
Fresno's not a bad place. You're the bad dude. You think LA's all cool, dude?
Is that what happened?
Really? You're talking a lot of shit about Fresno.
I think you're bad at words.
I think you're bad at comedy.
Okay, well, you're in the minority.
My job ain't words, brother.
I didn't realize the mayor of Fresno was here. They definitely didn't know who they were coming to see. That was so amazing. He's like, you're fucking with Fresno. Like, the last joke I did was about how Fresno is where you stop because everything else sucks. And he's like, yeah, fuck Fresno. What? I don't like words. And then he goes, my job isn't words. I'm like, yeah, I got that.
And she starts to walk away. By the way, I'm gonna need you to fucking, hey, concentrate. The tits left, concentrate, buddy. So she starts to walk away.
We had a funnier
joke. You had a what?
Oh, no.
You had a funnier joke. Now that's not what happened. You weren't listening to my joke. You did have a funnier joke. Do you want to have that funnier joke outside? Then fucking shut up. There are fucking balls on you, man. We had a funnier joke. What was I talking about? That's my fucking point. We had a funnier joke. I have no idea what you were saying, but I'm sure that mine was funnier. Where are you from, man? Oh, now you shut up. Good call. All right. Questions get harder after this one. What?
Skipton.
Okay, I'm American. I don't know what the fuck that is. So, I'm gonna skip right the fuck over you. So here's the story about the second worst person I ever met.
Fuck that guy!
I'm sure you're much funnier than me.
most important thing you need to know tonight is that I want you to have a good time. I truly do. I want you to leave this show saying that is the best damn comedy show I have ever seen.
You suck!
Who yelled that?
Okay, over there.
Can we get him out of here? Or do you want to apologize?
During intermission, he and his date went outside, and the staff did not let him back in.
Thank you. In the States, we don't usually do an interval during shows. We really just roll it through. And it was kind of good that we had that here, because we had a chance to Brexit that audience member. So,
thanks for watching. And thanks for subscribing on YouTube, following me on Instagram, and liking my page on Facebook. And of course, the Patreon. Patreon is one of the main ways I make a living right now, because I can't tour. If you want to support the Patreon and see videos before anyone else, go to patreon.com/Steve Hofstetter. You can also get some cool t-shirts there too, and video chat with me once a month. If you want updates on future tours, you can text the word Steve to 484848 if you're in the States, or you can text the word Steve to 393939 if you're in Canada. I still haven't found short codes in other countries. And of course, if you want to see me live right now, go to nowherecomedyclub.com. I do a 90-minute ad-lib show every Saturday night with Daniel Muggleton. I also perform full stand-up shows and do fun series like Director's Commentary, where I watch my old videos and heckle myself. Get your tickets now at nowherecomedyclub.com.